Well, here we are. Like a fortress, here we are. Hello there, fellow changelings of the Changeling Army. I'm the Game of Changeling Orstorm, and welcome back to Dread Templar. Last episode, well, we went through a sandy desert, got a nice reference to Counter-Strike. Now here we are.
Activated.
I know I was pretty much doing. That's cabin. By the way, in case you're wondering, the weapons will only be there for that specific level. Now, for instance, the gauntlet here, the secondary gauntlet that I got. It only applies just to this level. No other level. So, if I were to, like, go back to the beginning, I would not have a gauntlet. Yeah. I mean, granted, for the most part, this gauntlet is... probably a little bit overpowered, but... even then, I keep in mind one thing is that some of this, except for, of course, well, 1 through 3, episodes 1 through 3, I pretty well knew a good bit about this because of me playing through the game myself from early access. But even then, I had needed like a little refresher as to where some of the secrets were. I have to go down, don't I? Or do I? Thank you. Well, only one way to find out if it's thought or not. I can always load back up. I haven't gotten anything new. Okay, that actually just scared me. That's well done. Oh? Oh, it even breaks open. So if there's any side areas, it breaks it open. Jump when I shoot! No, that makes no sense! Oh, I can do it now, but... idea who this is. I legitimately don't. It could be a reference to Mortal Kombat based off the hat. It could be Raiden. But I have no idea who that's actually supposed to be. Unless that's supposed to be some other obscure reference. Then... I got nothing. See what I'm doing, huh? Oh, sorry. Sorry about that. How do they tell the chickens? Oh! Well, it took me a second to realize, but, there it is. There's the weapon to blood. Got a pitchfork and dynamite. Fortunately, there is no achievement for finding all the Easter eggs. I know there is in Prophet Warlock, and in Prophet Warlock 2. But I actually do hope that we get some more levels to that. I really hope we do. I mean, I am also excited like for some other stuff to actually come out. You know, now, I mean, I'm one. Alright. Ominous wet door. What the fuck? Okie doke, okay! Well, welcome to the Twisted Door and Filth Out of Hell. whatever. Just point me in the direction of demons. Demons to, feed. I can walk on it, but why would I want to walk on it? Someone's not dead. But who? Oh! Wait, hang on, this is from episode 4. Am I going backwards? I think I might be going backwards. Why would I be going backwards? Other than going backwards through various areas to find the door. shot. And the first part of it was, but... Oh, wait a minute. This is half-life! This is half-life! Then! So we had a Duke Nukem reference? Now half-life reference! Why jumping puzzle? Doing damage to them by using the thing to recover the... That sounds actually pretty good. And I'm gonna do save. Okay, that's something that needs to be fixed as soon as possible, where the character will not move when they jump. Where we started. everything. I can just make a big green mix. Things aren't that they were supposed to be. I do play. And next is acting up because of the way I'm sitting. Okay, so that's where the level ends. Good to know. Wait, this is a tutorial! There we go. What? That's on me. Alright, well, down we go! That's nice. character to do something like running.
appreciate this place I built for you. I can imagine how wonderful it would feel to relive that unforgettable night. I didn't kill you then, so the power inside you could awaken to its full potential. It has grown to such an extent that I can even smell its perfection. Come out. I've been waiting for too long. The dread force in your body is calling for its new master.
I'm never gonna let you have this power. I'm gonna pay for what you did.
Okay. It's finally over. This nightmare that's imprisoned me for the last 20 years has finally ended. After these ordeals and pain, I don't seem to be able to leave this place. Well, no longer matters. After this final battle, my rest is well deserved. My exhaustion is finally caught up to me.
And that's it. That's Red Templar. Well done. Now, I legitimately actually expect that Mr. Forest Friend to actually voice act this. I really did. Anything else? Or, nope, that's it. That's it. That's the end of the game. Oh, and of course it does have New Game Plus, so I can be able to play through the game if I really want to. Why doesn't it want me to? And it does say like what I have. You know what this does? Well, while I'm getting to join the New Game Plus here, why don't we give my thoughts about the game? So we're gonna... Well, with what I've... And of course this is going off of like what I played before. I actually thought the game was really, really fun to play. Now granted, yes, I mean, I did like legitimately play this when it first came out in Early Access, and it was fun. It was absolutely fun to play. Especially, I mean, a lot of this, and I do mean like a lot of this, is referential to, I guess you could say, the game itself, because, well, I mean, there's a lot of, I guess, like, Quake influence in this. And I will say that the main, I guess today the main story point about this was more or less figuring out like what exactly is going on in terms of this. Like what exactly is going on, why exactly does this guy want to do like what he does. And so enough, we finally found out. The main, I guess, the selling point, at least to me, was more or less basically being, like, it was like a retro shooter in a sense, kind of akin to Quake. I mean, granted, one of the plays that we did go was inspired by the legitimate Quake. As you're probably wondering about how you get to the secret, it's that. And that's pretty well right about at the ending of the first level. And the use of the bullet time function was actually really good. I did like that idea because, well, truth be told, it did make like this game a lot easier to maneuver around. And of course the wounds. The wounds are also part of it as well. I mean, I already got some wounds on me right now. And you have to, of course, go out of your way to find some of the wounds or even figure out like the puzzle act we do with that specific thing. And now, this right here. The photo to the evil headless necromancer zone has been activated. Will you be able to face the resurrected legion and take down to attain the Halloween wound honking curse for your trap lancer? This was something that was introduced when Halloween rolled around. You can do this whenever. And here we are.
Activated. Deactivated.
The way I thought was actually fairly good as well. This looks more like basically some kid that had like a traumatic experience and he was given a choice to actually, in a sense, basically alleviate the fear. Essentially, basically
activated.
Conquer that which he feared. And he did so.
Deactivated.
As you plainly saw. And, I mean, I did like the idea that like, each one has, like, its own separate... I think of, like, each weapon has, like, its own separate ammo, which I do like. And each area was different, like, each area had, like, its own uniqueness to it. Like, for instance, like, the entirety of the first area was just all about pretty much a graveyard. Then we moved on to... essentially were dungeons. And what else? And then after that, we moved on to... The second area was all about pretty much ice. And then afterwards we were in like a library. Then sand. And then of course finally the nightmare itself. I mean, I did like all of that. Oh, by the way, this is also how you can actually get an early bow and whatnot. Now, of course, I already got the trap launcher off camera, of course, but you go here, it's 20, there you go. Or you can also do this to get this as well. And there you go. Done and done. What else can I say?
As far as I can remember, my grandfather had always been by my side.
The other thing I guess I could also say about this is the side areas. Like, I mean, the side areas in themselves were actually pretty good. I guess you could say the only thing that I didn't necessarily like about the runes was more or less basically being that, I have to essentially go out of my way to find the gems, the blood gems, in order to unlock, like, the specific area. To unlock something, so that I could actually be able to utilize it. Now, I'm not saying that's a bad thing, I'm not saying that, but you get the idea. Not that I'm mostly just rambling on, just a few in time. What else? I'm trying to think, like, what else could I think good about this? The New Game Plus, I do feel like, I mean, granted, they're supposed to have higher health, but it doesn't look like they do. Then again, that's probably just because I get this thing on. Some of the, runes, trying to get, like, some of the runes. I feel like that has been a little cumbersome because some of the runes actually require you to do like specific jumps or things around that line, and it really shows how bad it is. There we go. Now, as for, I guess you could say, like the upgrades. Upgrades I find are actually really, really good. I do find that those are actually really good. Oh! Oh, those were the things that we fought! Enemy variants, for the enemy variants, I find like each of the enemy variants are fairly good, but I wouldn't necessarily say they're all good. Bosses? I do feel like some of the bosses are actually fairly good. Like the Hell Knight here is actually fairly good. Lifting. Now I know that very well, like I was pretty well made, like the final boss an absolute joke. But and of course with reason, because it's obvious. The voice acting in it, even though it was still because there wasn't a whole lot of voice acting in this, was good. I legitimately thought that it was Ganini Matoato. Mr. Forest Friend's Twitter himself. And I even found out, while waiting for this game before we come out, that he actually was actually part of, Madness Project Nexus, which I found to be rather interesting, very, very interesting. Now, granted, yes, I do realize that that's been, was quite a while ago, and he is actually uncredited, but he does do, the doc, 2B, in the game. He actually does do 2B. Now, as for, I guess, say, other voice acting, eh. Well, that didn't take much time at all. The music in this is absolutely amazing. I absolutely love the music in this. The aesthetics, aesthetics are great. I mean, this feels like it's almost like a Quake clone, if you actually want to see that. Or heck, even a Quake mod. And granted, it came out, this was 3 years in development. Fair enough. The only con I guess I could have for it is that sometimes the jump does not work, and I do feel like you could put the jump to where it as if basically you can jump while standing still. I know other games do it. I do know that other games have done that in the past. I really don't know what else to say. So I guess since we I am still selling off like the new game plus here a little bit. I might have finished up this level here. But aside from, well, the game sometimes not wanting to work with me, but that, as I said, that's pretty much it might be on my part, I don't know. But regardless though, I will say that to the person who actually made this game, well done. This is actually a really good game, and I can see the inspiration behind this of Quake. I can see a lot of Quake, heck, even the flames there. Dang, it looks very similar to Quake. I'm not gonna bother doing the secret since I already got it. But yeah, that's Dread Templar. As I said, this amazing game for what it is. I really did enjoy actually playing this, even from actually playing this myself when it was in early access. It is well done. Well, I suppose I should probably wrap this up here, as I'm getting about that's probably going to take over in a few seconds. Up to 5 minutes over an hour here, so. Either way, I do hope you enjoyed watching me play through Dread Templar. The link to this will be in the description below to all parts of this if you want to check this game out for yourself. I was using a trainer on this just for obvious reasons, because it's how I play the game. I always play it, if possible, with at least infinite ammo. That's it, at least. Regardless, though, if you don't want to play with that, just go right on ahead. It's totally up to you. It's just how I like to play some of my games. Either way, be sure to also check out other games that Foghorn Publishing they published. Even from other people. I know Foghorn Pundit with Lord and Belaine's, which I know part of his gaming has done. I've checked it out, but I'm not really much of a city builder guy. Anyway, I'm moving on it. Get this done. Anyway, as they said before, if you want to check this game out for yourself, a link will be in the description below. And as well, subscribe if you want to check out other videos I've done in the past, or to stay tuned for future videos on the channel. Comment down below what you think of this game, or if you have another game you want me to check out on the channel, be sure to let me know down below. Until next time, stay 20% cooler, and I'll see you in the next video, my friends. Bye-bye.